So what would you think if I were to tell you that you could get an 8-driver earphone for $60? Well, this is what we have today in this review. I'm looking at the CCA CA16. It's an 8-driver unit. It has one dynamic driver and 7 balanced armature drivers. So, how does it sound? Let's find out. What's cracking, audio fans? It's David here from Prime Audio Reviews, and here they are, the CCA. Now, we all know that CCA is the sister company of the KZ Reptilian Overlords. So that is how they are able to present us with these fantastic deals. Just $60 for 8 drivers. We'll get right to it. Starting with the shells here. They're fairly standard, fairly low-key shell. At least from this angle they are. Nothing unusual about them. They look fairly nice. Just a typical acrylic shell. Glossy piano black with the CCA logo on the front. You can see they've got the QDC type 2-pin sockets there, which are the current standard for CCA and KZ and Blon and a couple of other brands. You've got an aluminium nozzle, and I will mention here that the nozzle is thinner in diameter than average. So just keep that in mind if you are someone who generally uses third-party ear tips, not the stock ones. You might have a harder time finding ones that will fit on here and stick on there. In terms of comfort, these are fantastic for me. Like I said, they're fairly ordinary from this angle, but when you turn them on the side like this, you can see they're fairly wide, and that's because they've got 8 drivers stuffed inside. So they didn't have any choice other than to do that. But in terms of comfort, these are really, really good, for, at least for me. I can wear these for all day long without any problems. And the noise isolation, passive noise isolation, is very good on these as well. But yeah, very comfortable, very light, and you know, fairly ordinary, but a nice solid build quality. Now to the cable real quick, and yes, it is that dreaded brown KZ cable. So it's a tangly little bastard. Every chance it gets, it will wind itself in knots, and you'll have a cable full of bullshit. But the actual quality of the cable itself is not bad. You know, it's got a nice tight braid. We've got a rubberized Y-split there, no chin slider, preformed ear hooks or ear guides. But yeah, like I said, it's very prone to tangling, but otherwise it's quite good. Of course, because it's detachable, it's not too difficult if you want to swap it out for another cable, although keep in mind that not all cables will sit flush because of this connector type here, but it's not too difficult to find ones that work. So let's move right onto the sound now. Overall, these have a slight V-shaped signature, tight and punchy bass, a very smooth signature. It's a very relaxed, kind of laid-back presentation. Good clarity, decent detail retrieval, and a fairly non-aggressive treble. So to break that down a bit, starting with the bass, the 7mm dynamic driver in these has got a good deal of impact. It's kind of boosted a little bit north of neutral, but it's not a big bass. This is not a bass head IEM, but it's fairly quick. It's got a nice well-defined leading edge and a medium paced decay on it, so it sounds quite natural. The level of the bass is just a little bit ahead of the mid-range, and overall it's just a good quality bass. The sub bass does fall off a little bit, but really these can get a nice rumble going. A couple of songs I was listening to, they kind of surprised me, and I was like, damn, they can bring the rumble when they want to. So yeah, overall the bass is nice. Now the mid-range is buttery smooth. You know, it reminds me quite a lot of the first CCA model that I tried a long time ago. It was the CCA C10, and at the time I said they were buttery smooth, and these are kind of like that as well. They have these very lush mid-range, which is still articulate, still has good clarity, but it's just really smooth. And some people will love that, and other people not so much. The mid-range is slightly recessed, like I said, it sits just behind the bass and to a lesser extent the treble, but very lush, very rich. You know, the tone is quite good. It's not 100% accurate, but you can't really expect that for $60. But overall, you know, vocals sound nice. Male vocals are a little bit recessed more so than female vocals, but overall the mid-range is satisfying. And finally, moving on to the treble. The treble again here is quite smooth. When you look at the graph, in case I haven't popped up the graph yet, here it is now. In terms of treble, it is kind of forward in the lower treble, but again, it's just like the overall signature. It's very smoothly presented. There isn't any harshness. It does on occasion sound like it's leaning towards sibilance, but it never actually gets there. But then after the peak at around, I think it's around 7 to 8 kilohertz, it starts to fall off quite rapidly. So there's not a lot of upper treble presence, which limits the airiness to a degree. So they don't have a really light and airy sound, but there is a good amount of treble detail there, not so much micro detail, and it's not the most precise treble. So if you like a lively, very forward treble, these aren't the IEM for you. But if you're looking for something that's very, very laid back, but still with a good amount of detail, very smooth and non-fatiguing and good for long listening sessions, these are a great option. I forgot to mention that the mid-range resolution is also quite good, and the instrument separation is good as well, which you would expect when you're talking about 8 drivers. And I kind of applaud CCA for the engineers for not sort of making everything big and bold and just pushing the most out of all the 8 drivers. They've taken a very mature tuning approach with it and just ended up with something that is pleasant to listen to, a nice punchy bass, buttery smooth mid-range, and a treble that is kind of forward but at the same time is very non-fatiguing and very smooth. All right, so to sum up, what do I like about the CCA CA16? I love the comfort. They're very comfortable. I like the passive noise isolation, which is above average. And you know, I actually love this sort of low key, very plain, just a plain black appearance. I like that. And I like the fact that it has a non-fatiguing, sort of a chill presentation. What I don't like about these, obviously I do not like this cable. Just because of those tangles, it's very frustrating. But you know, apart from that, at times I do wish there was a little more energy in the sound. I would have liked a little more upper treble energy just to get that airiness and to expand the sound stage a little bit. You know, the sound stage on these is, it's not small, it's not tiny or too intimate, but it's fairly average in size. But a little bit of extra lift in the upper treble just would have opened the sound up a bit more and widened the stage somewhat. But overall, for $60, yeah, these are a good buy. Before I finish up here, I'll just do a quick comparison with a couple of things. First of all, this is the TRN VX. This is a 7-driver IEM. It has one dynamic driver and 6 balanced armature drivers. This has a magnesium alloy shell compared to the acrylic one on the CCA. Comfort wise, pretty good. For me, not quite as comfortable as the CA16. But in terms of sound, the VX has a brighter signature. It has fairly thin, lean mid-range notes, but it does have excellent resolution. It also has a more lively and forward treble, which is more precise and more detailed. And these are very good at revealing micro details in music. So if that's your thing, you know, give these a consideration. But overall, I think just in terms of pure sound, most people are probably going to prefer the sound of the CA16 because it's just not as aggressive. And the VX here can be fatiguing over time with that treble energy and the brightness. And here we have the iBasso Audio IT00. Some of you may have known if you watch my other videos that this is currently my favorite sub $100 IEM. I still prefer the IT00 over these because they have a more forward mid-range. Vocals are a bit more intimate and a bit more engaging. They do have a little bit of additional upper treble energy, so they do sound a little bit more open in the higher frequencies. And the sub bass is a little more forward on these. It doesn't fall off compared to the CA16. So my preference would still be for these, but if you want something a little less bassy and something that is very smooth, buttery smooth and non-fatiguing, yeah, definitely the CCA is worth a recommendation. I think this is a good IEM and I'm really looking forward to see what these guys do next. And that's about it for this video. If you liked it, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, Parfam audiophile style. Hit the subscribe button if you haven't already and you want to see more videos like this in the future. And until next time, I'll see you later.